Can you tell us a little bit about this mission?
This program started in 2007, and all the development of the first spacecraft took a bit more than 7 years, and the first satellite was launched in June 2015. So we have already a satellite orbiting the Earth since about 15 months. Now, Sentinel-2 is a mission from Copernicus. Copernicus is a very large European program co-financed by the European Space Agency and by the European Commission. And now a number of final functional tests will be concluded. And if successful, the satellite should be authorized to be shipped to South America, French Guiana, where Europe has its launch base. And it will be launched on the early period in March by a Vega launcher. The aim of that program is to monitor all facets of the planet Earth in terms of resources, surface, it could address atmosphere chemistry, emerging land surfaces, ocean. There are plenty of applications around Copernicus. Copernicus is a set of 6 missions, and Sentinel-2 is only one of them.
And when would you consider this mission successful?
Alors, this mission is successful basically when the users are telling to us that they are happy about what we deliver. The very end customer for Sentinel-2 is a large group, more than 2,000 not only institutes but also companies who process the data to deliver services in very different areas. Like I mentioned, for example, piloting better the agriculture, reducing the amount of fertilizer which are required. So those sort of end users basically are the ones who are the witness of our success.
So if I summarize for you, the success of this mission really goes beyond the Iron Triangle.
Yes, it does. Of course, what you call nicely the Iron Triangle is something which is important to respect, because ESA is mainly living from taxpayers' money. And we need to keep a full credibility and be respected for the quality of our business. And we should not always come back to our delegation and beg for more when we promise that we would deliver the spacecraft within this sort of schedule and this pot of money. But behind that, much more important is the satisfaction of the users, and basically the use that you could make for such accurate data delivery to monitor and to control the resources of the planet.
How can you make sure that actually you are able to deliver according to what the end user is expecting? Because there's multiple end users and multiple requirements resulting from that.
Now, what we try to do is first, when we have an idea of an objective of mission to be defined, we look at what exists around us and what is planned by others to be developed. What do the Americans do? What do the Japanese do? The Chinese now are emerging as well as a space power, the Indians. And then we know already what is a sort of a state of the art in this sort of observation. Then, of course, our role is to push the European industry to learn and to bring further the ball. And then we derive mission requirements that are more demanding than what we know is already achieved. Based on those mission requirements, we select through a complex process the best industries in the field, and we choose especially European industries because we work on taxpayers' money from Europe, and we organize those industries to deliver all the bits and pieces. Sometimes the bits are very big and the pieces are very expensive, and they get developed, prototyped, qualified, assembled to create the spacecraft that you see behind you.
Did you face any obstacle in developing this?
Alors, we face obstacles, and the sort of type of obstacles vary depending on the stage of development where you stand. At the very start, you play with technologies that you may not have used before. And sometimes, very early technologies present a lot of risk, and they don't behave exactly as you would have expected. Very later on, at integration level, it could be more stupid. It could be that because of the schedule pressure, the group of engineers realizing the test and the integration make a mistake. Moving the spacecraft once, the Star Tracker package has been eating an element which was in the clean room, and the Star Tracker package was damaged. We had to review the processes to make sure that this doesn't reoccur again. And problems like that, I have probably about 15 that I could report to you today.
Thanks a lot.